In its summer series with the NBC Symphony Orchestra, under our guest conductor for today, Massimo Freccia, musical director of the New Orleans Symphony Orchestra. His program includes Van Weber's overture to Der Freischütz, Paul Hindemith's symphonic metamorphosis of themes by Carl Maria von Weber, Samuel Barber's Adagio for strings, and Respighi's The Pines of Rome. Our NBC concert begins with Carl Maria von Weber's overture to his opera Der Freischütz. When first produced in Berlin in 1821, the opera made history with its success. Von Weber recorded in his diary that it was received with incredible enthusiasm, and his contemporary Berlioz paid tribute to the overture by writing, "No one dreams of disputing its preeminence." Our conductor, Massimo Freccia, is acknowledging the applause of our studio audience and will now conduct the NBC Symphony Orchestra in Carl Maria von Weber's overture to Der Freischütz.
Thank you.
Following Van Weber's overture to Der Freischütz, we hear the symphonic metamorphosis on themes of Van Weber by the contemporary composer Paul Hindemith. Written in 1943, the symphonic metamorphosis makes use of themes from four different Van Weber compositions. The first movement is derived from the Allegro in A minor number 4 of Van Weber's Eight Pieces for Piano Four Hands, written in 1818. The second movement is taken from the introduction to Van Weber's incidental music for Schiller's drama Turandot. The third movement is based on the Andantino con moto in C minor number 2 of Six Pieces for Piano Four Hands, opus 10. The final movement is taken from the Marcia in G minor number 7 of the Eight Pieces for Piano Four Hands. Massimo Freccia and the NBC Symphony Orchestra play now Hindemith's Symphonic Metamorphosis on themes by Van Weber.
Thank you. Thank you.
Massimo Cresta and the NBC Symphony Orchestra have just performed Hindemith's Symphonic Metamorphosis on themes by Carl Maria von Weber. And our audience is particularly pleased, it seems, with these modern adaptations of themes by the early Romantic master. Our concert will be continued immediately after a pause for station identification.
Where there's smoke, there's fire. And where there's a forest fire, you can depend on it 9 times out of 10 that some thoughtless person was careless with fire. 9 out of every 10 forest fires are man-made. When you're in the country, please be extra careful with fire. Don't throw lighted cigarettes or cigars from your automobile. Break matches in half before you throw them away. Be careful of hot pipe ashes. And before you make a campfire, check local fire laws carefully. Then, when you finish with your fire, drown it, stir, and then drown and stir again. America's forests are vital. Don't allow them to be destroyed by thoughtlessness. Be careful at all times, especially during these summer vacation days when many families travel to wooded areas for picnics and outings. Remember, 9 out of every 10 forest fires are man-made. Don't be one of the guilty 9.
Today's concert with Massimo Freccia and the NBC Symphony Orchestra continues now with the Adagio for Strings by the young American composer Samuel Barber. The work was written originally for string quartet as the slow movement of the quartet in B minor. In its present arrangement for string orchestra, Adagio for Strings was given its world premiere by the NBC Symphony Orchestra under Arturo Toscanini in November of 1938. There is the applause marking the return to the podium of our conductor today, Massimo Freccia. Now he will be heard with the NBC Symphony in Samuel Barber's Adagio for Strings.
Thank you.
quiet, meditative, and moving music was the Adagio for Spring, Samuel Barber, played by Massimo Fletcher and the NBC Symphony. The concluding work in today's NBC Symphony concert, Ottorino Respighi's The Pines of Rome, was written in 1924 as the second of three works in which, as the composer says, he uses nature as a point of departure to recall visions and memories. The visions here are four. First, the pines of the Villa Borghese, children at play in the pine grove, dancing and mimicking soldiers. Next, the pines near a catacomb. From the depths rises a chant echoing like a hymn. Thirdly, the pines of the Ianiculum, in which the score indicates that a nightingale's song is to be reproduced by means of a phonograph record. Finally, the pines of the Appian Way, with the vision of the glories of ancient armies at sunrise on the sacred way. Massimo Freccia and the NBC Symphony Orchestra play Respighi's The Pines of Rome.
Thank you.
stately pines along the Appian Way, evoking glories of the ancient Roman legion, and marking the conclusion of this performance of Ettore Respighi's The Pines of Rome. The concluding work, incidentally, in this concert by the NBC Symphony Orchestra with Massimo Fletcher as our conductor. Here's Maestro Fletcher again. He signals the men of the orchestra to rise and share this thickening applause with them. Now shaking hands with our concertmaster these past weeks, Max Hollander. And with this performance of Respighi's The Pines of Rome, we have concluded today's concert with Massimo Fletcher and the NBC Symphony Orchestra. Earlier on the program, we heard von Weber's overture to Der Freischütz, Paul Hindemith's Symphonic Metamorphosis on Themes by von Weber, and Samuel Barber's Adagio for Strings. Next week, at the same time, Massimo Fletcher will again appear as guest conductor of the NBC Symphony Orchestra in the second of his three scheduled appearances. Next week's program will include Vivaldi's Concerto in D Minor, the Richard Strauss tone poem Don Juan, La Oración del Torero by Turina, and Tchaikovsky's overture fantasy Romeo and Juliet. We cordially invite you to join us then over your favorite NBC station. Today's program was heard in Canada over the facilities of the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation. Your engineer was Charles Gray, your producer Don Gillis. Ben Grauer speaking.
This is NBC, the National Broadcasting Company.